guys, Chris here. Welcome to the Thomann YouTube channel. We're back and look who I found. The one and only Martin Miller. Awesome, dude. Thank you for coming.
Thanks for having me.
It's so great. I was waiting for this moment for many weeks, actually, since I figured out that Ibanez has something really interesting and brand new coming out. And you are heavily involved in the whole process, right?
That's true, yeah. So we're obviously talking about the Ibanez AC series,
which
is the brand new model series. Not just the brand new model; it's an entirely new range of guitars for 2018. Yeah, and I was involved with the actual development, and obviously I got my own little model here available on the market.
We just figured out that our taste in guitar colors is
it's very similar.
Pretty similar.
Yeah. dude, I'm telling you, choosing this color was one of the heaviest decisions of my life.
I believe you.
I don't have a child yet, but imagine that picking a child's name is probably harder than this, but this is close.
I think it's about
this
the same
close.
Thing. Because
like,
that's a special moment you get on Ibanez signature
that's
guitar.
Once in a lifetime. And yeah, you got to make it count.
If I had a hat, I would have raised it already.
Yeah,
awesome, dude.
Really, it's a big, great. That's the biggest lifetime achievement I've unlocked so far. Possibly. Yeah.
On your bucket list.
Yeah, exactly.
Check.
I mean, so, come on, who hasn't dreamed of this when they were 15?
Come on,
be honest.
I remember because I'm old. I had cell phones back in the days. Let's just put it this way. You had the chance to like type in some kind of own pictures and stuff.
You had to paint it yourself?
Yeah, you had a software on your computer, and you could have, click all the pixels in what you wanted to show it, and you save it and send it as an SMS. My background picture was Ibanez.
Of course.
I mean, I was so obsessed with the brand, and that for a very good reason. Yeah. So I totally get it.
With people like us, I assume you grew up in the 90s like
yeah.
me.
Yeah.
Guitar player growing up in the 90s, who didn't own an Ibanez? I mean, it's just impossible, and there's still still that status symbol.
Absolutely, it's
just the way it is. Yeah.
So we were talking a little bit about the past. Can you tell us just very briefly a little about something? Some of you guys don't know Martin. You have to check him out. He has an awesome YouTube channel. You can buy all the albums and go watch him live. It's an experience. I'm very impressed. And
sweet,
you go.
Yeah, Martin Miller. I'm from Leipzig. I'm a professional guitar player. Mostly a freelance type musician. I make music, I produce, I mix. This has been sort of, I've been wandering off in all types of directions. So there's the part of me that is a guitar player, a session musician. I record guitars for other people. I make original music. I do clinics. I mix and produce. Right now I just mixed my girlfriend's new record that's due very soon. Yeah.
Cool, very nice.
So I'm having my hands in all kinds of stuff. I teach jazz guitar at Dresden College of Music.
Oh, well, there you go.
Yeah, so all sorts of things going on at the moment. I guess I'm sort of a brand ambassador for Ibanez and Laney. So yeah,
that's
spreading
really,
the word.
Really crazy. How come this this connection,
With Ibanez? Yeah, it actually came through the Laney connection. The people at Ibanez showed up while I was performing at the NEM booth of Laney, and yeah, a week later I got an email. They wanted to start working with me professionally, and things took off from there.
Wow. It sounds like a typical daydream.
Guitar player's dream.
Somebody writes me an email, and I'm like, wow.
Yeah, that's one thing. If I can give some advice for young guitar players. I see a lot of young guitar players out there who try to force those things, and they might force them a bit too early. Forcing things can shy people away. And you might actually prevent those things from happening. So the advice I have, if you want to have a career like this, is just do your work.
Yeah.
Do your homework, show up, be friendly.
Oh yeah.
Do what people ask you to, and do it properly, and then those things will fall in place. I strongly believe that the world will adjust around you when you just do your thing and stick to it. So yeah. For example, I had my first string endorsement with IQS. My first endorsement overall, I was 27, and then I had the amp endorsement at age 30, and a year later the guitar endorsement, and 2 years later I had the signature guitar. So I wasn't forcing it. I was not somebody who was out there chasing endorsements like crazy. I just let it happen, and then it happened naturally.
Then we eventually arrived to the guitars.
Yes.
So when did it start and how did it go on and develop?
Mm-hmm. So I got an email from the Ibanez people a couple months into our professional relationship, probably around the end of 2015. And they just briefly described what was going on. It's like, hey, we're trying to come up with this new guitar here and we really would want your input. And that, I mean, come on, how incredible is that, that a brand that has been around for so long and has so many
such
artists,
a reputation and everything,
yes, yeah. Such a reputation comes up to their smaller time artists like myself and goes, hey, we want your input, we appreciate your opinion. Eventually they showed up at my doorstep in November 2015 in my hometown in Leipzig. Yeah. They came to my place. They came traveling from LA to snowy ding, Leipzig. Ding. They rang at my door, I let them in. I mean, I have a tiny place. There were five people stood in my tiny studio, my home studio. And we were discussing guitars. Back in the day, they just brought a piece of body wood, which was very similarly shaped to this, and like filled up with files and tons of files, like with hundreds and thousands of designs of headstocks, logos, neck profiles, color, paint jobs, those kind of things.
All the options and everything.
And yeah, we just went through the options and I just grabbed all my guitars and said, I think this one has the best neck. I think this one has the best sounding pickups. I really like how this one sustains. I think this tremolo stays in tune the best, etc. So we just collected ideas and they did that with a couple of other artists. And I'm very pleased to see that a lot of things that I was really begging for, so to say, ended up in the guitars. Like I remember very, very consciously mentioning that we really should have two types of guitars in this range, humbucker one with 24 frets, an HSS one with 22 frets. We gotta have a vintage tremolo that moves both directions because this is supposed to be your desert island guitar. So what you gotta be able to do pretty much every gig on it and rely on it. Like when you travel, it's the only guitar you're taking. A double locking tremolo is not really as awesome as they are or as awesome as they can be. They're not as reliable in performance as this. If you break a string, you're done.
You're done.
Yeah. You're done. With this one, you change the strings in a minute.
In a minute, yeah.
Even if you're as clumsy as me, it takes you a minute.
And if you want, you know, alternative tunings, that's not that much of a pain in the ass because you actually can like drop it.
Yeah. Or if you don't have a tech, what if you need to retune during a gig, a double locking tremolo? Fine tuners are maxed out. What are you gonna do? Get the wrench out and start working on it? Yeah. No, it's just not
it's
possible.
Terrible. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. By the way, what's also very important, if you notice, we changed the design of the headstock. It was a very big discussion. Should they keep the trademark destroyer pointy headstock or should they exchange it for something more mellow? And I think this is a good compromise because this is reminiscent of the old headstock, but it also makes it more applicable. It's not just that There's the old trademark, yes, but also you have to be able to show up at a gig where there are non-guitar players.
Yeah.
Like, let's say you play a country or a folk gig and you show up with a pointy guitar that makes it kind of inappropriate for certain things.
Exactly. Or some guitar players actually just find that way too 80s, 90s, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And they just want to have a guitar that's as much traditional, as modern, as just, you know, just a beautiful thing to look at. Yeah. You know, it's a very nice mixture, and it actually brings back the, I think it was 70s headstock and
the Roadster. It's similar. And the logo is too. Yeah.
Exactly. That's just the right thing to do. Yeah. Absolutely. I'm on the same opinion. And let's move on. Mm-hmm. All the specs and all the details were mentioned in dozens of videos already. We'll go through them, but I don't really want to concentrate on each and every of them because we'll end up with a 2 hours video, and you guys probably know all these things already, but these are that's actually the Prestige model, which is the Japanese one. So they are very similar in many things, the premium one and the Prestige one, but there are of course some differences. So this particular guitar has the awesome locking tuners, which are also staggered, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the first one are way lower than the last one to keep the angle pretty much the same, and that you don't have too much pressure on the string tree, which could be a point that, you know, causes problems with the tuning stability. And it's very impressive.
I'm gonna tell you, did you see me tune this guitar before we started filming?
Not at all.
And it's winter right now.
The guitars were so cold.
I've been traveling for 6 days with this guitar now. I haven't even tuned it up. We just recorded the jam. It was fine.
Yeah, it was perfectly tuned. Yeah. And I tuned all the other guitars just to make sure that they're, you know, ready to rumble. Not much at all to do.
But this this one is perfectly set up for my needs. Didn't even have to tune it.
And you know, you have an awesome bone nut, which is also not very typical nowadays, but it's, if you ask me, the best solution because it's very sturdy, it's hard, and you don't have to lubricate it because it's
self-lubricating.
It's just the best thing to use, and it sounds very, you know, rich in the harmonics and everything, all the nice frets and everything, but and this is the first and the last thing that counts, for me at least, is the neck profile. Mm-hmm. Because if you want to be honest to yourself, you will like or dislike a guitar because of what you feel before you even, you know, stick a cable in it. And that is not a visor neck.
Not a single person has complained about the neck so far. And I've literally seen dozens and dozens of people pick up these guitars nobody complains. It's just
the perfect
topically the dead center of the field, you know? It's neither too big nor too thin, not too narrow, not too wide. I mean, I think there a lot of thought went into the development of this and a lot of input, and it seems to please everybody, so that's a very good thing. It's also, it's a perfect tone issue, right? You gotta have some wood, you gotta have some resonation.
It feels right as well, and you know, If you play more of a vintage bluesy style and you use your thumb a lot, it's gonna work. It's not too big that you struggle, you know, going around the neck. If you play your traditional classical style playing and your thumb is all the time at the back, it's perfect. It's awesome.
A couple months before the official release date of the AZ, the people from Ibanez and I met. We talked some business stuff. Received a new prototype, and we wanted to talk about where we're gonna take this.
Yeah.
What's the guitar gonna be? What do we have planned for the next year, etc. And boom, there they set the magic words, signature guitar. So I was very close to tears in that moment, as you can imagine. It was like goosebumps all over.
Oh yeah.
And so yeah, then I had some time to think about what I wanted in this instrument to. That should be different. I knew that I didn't want to change much because, as you know, it's a perfectly balanced instrument. Like the neck profile, the choice of neck woods, everything is designed to be one thing, right?
Yeah. And all the curves and everything.
I didn't want to disturb the pros too much. They know what they're doing. So, but what I really wanted to have, and that is unique in the AZ range so far, and it's a very personal choice. I wanted to have the mahogani wood, as you can see. So this is mahogany bodywood. It's the only guitar in the range that has that. Yeah.
So no alder.
No alder. Not that I don't like the alder ones. My prototypes have been alder.
Okay.
But
which we can show at this point.
Yeah. Let's show them. So this is actually, let's do the whole history.
Okay.
This is prototype number one.
Yeah.
This is what I received in late 2015. Late 2016. That was the very first one. A bit more plain looking.
Yeah,
but still. The basic ingredients were there already. The neck profile was pretty much dead on at this point. As you can see, it has a deeper roast, like compared to the other ones. At this point, they were still experimenting with the degrees of roasting that they had to apply to give it the perfect stability. So there they overdid it a little, as you can see. So yeah, but it was pretty much there already. I have a different logo on that one, if you can see it, which is
That's
very cool.
That's the traditional one with the...
So I appreciate this guitar for being very unique in that regard. It's definitely nice to have. As you can see, I also changed for my signature guitar was the hardware. I wanted to have something that blends in a little bit more with the futuristic look. But yeah, definitely the mahogany, and the prototypes have a bit of this a darker sound. I'm not an expert on wood, but I just knew something that about mahogany that is me, I identify with that, and also it would be cool if we offered that in the range. Even if somebody doesn't know me or doesn't care about me or my signature instrument, they have that option. So in my opinion, it's a bit more of a balanced sound, whereas this is a bit more of a dark sound.
That makes perfect sense because of your playing. You also play awesome jazz, of course, and if you play clean, you tend to use humbucker, warmer sounds, which fits perfectly to mahogany. So
I want the guitar to be perfectly balanced in the spectrum, because when I play jazz, I use the tone knob to back it down, and when I play rock, I I turn it back up and it's very aggressive. Yeah. So mm-hmm. I need the guitar, again, to be in the middle of all of that so I can go off in both directions. Yeah. Maybe you can strum a G chord. I don't know if the camera will pick this up, but we can at least give it a try.
Maybe the labs.
Yeah, yeah. And this?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? Yeah, this is brighter.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a bit more balanced, whereas this one is a bit more...
Yeah, mid-humby, which is interesting.
Yeah, mid-humby.
Exactly. Interesting.
So that's got to be the wood. And obviously, I got
it. It's also reliced.
This one I reliced myself
by dropping it.
Yeah, and awesome. it's literally, at this point, it's the only top like this out there, and I have it, and I dropped it. I'm an idiot. So that's just the way it goes. So yeah, and I got the little scribble, ugly scribble up here, obviously.
Well, I see two M's, so I think
We call it, the people at my distribution, when they received this and shipped it onto me, they unpacked it, and it's called, oh, it says Mimi. So this is Mimi.
Oh, crazy.
And for all the Germans, we came up with this little thing. Ohne Mimi geht der Martin nie ins Bett.
Ohne Mimi. You want to translate it?
Oh, no, it can't be. You know that song, Ohne Mimi geht der Martin nie ins Bett?
Yeah. Alrighty. Oh man,
that was one of the middle
sweet.
Positions.
Awesome.
Yeah,
that is.
You can see this guitar has some serious clean tones built in. You know, I'm, you know, like Picasso went through the blue phase. Not that I'm the Picasso of guitar, but I'm right now going through the clean phase where I just sit at home, enjoy a good clean tone, and just go And this guitar has it all. You don't need to have the single coils to.
That's interesting.
To have
the
clean tones, especially with this switch right here. Like if you want to check this out. Slightly rewires the pickups, gives them a different output, and you know that's the magic behind the electronics. Yeah. Not that I can explain this, but so much fun to play just a G chord.
Wow.
With this. Basically,
Whoa.
You're getting 10 sounds for the price of 5.
It almost sounds like a salesman.
That was really cheap. I'm sorry.
but it's you know, exactly the point. Yeah.
So yeah.
Let's just check out the HSS. I have the Jet City Amelia on a clean channel right now, and I have a little bit of Canyon Love from Electroharmonics, and the neck pickup of this beautiful guitar.
You're gonna try on the neck pickup because I tested my friend Tom Quayle's signature model.
All right.
And the sound that I find absolutely ridiculously awesome. Try the neck pickup and switch the Dyna-Switch or the dynamic switch as they call it.
On. Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
That gives it some serious spank.
Let's just try it without and to hear what makes difference it makes. Thank you. really sweet. At this point, if you turn this on, it doesn't remind me of any guitars I know.
Yeah.
It just gives me a different voicing. So Martin will play us a little bit on a backing track. Have fun and come back next time. We'll be online every Thursday with new stuff. You can subscribe and everything. And Martin, very nice to have you in the studio.
Likewise.
And thank you very much for all the cool information and everything. And have fun and have luck and all the best to everything coming up and the reception of your very beautiful guitar.
Oh yeah, I want to say thank you for the gracious people at Thomann for having me. Thank you very much.
Of course, you're always welcome.
Thank you to the great people at Ibanez and Lady for providing me with their stuff, and of course thank you guys for checking this out. Hope you pick one of these up, and if you do, let me know. I want to know your feedback.